some of you are aware, I had my fair struggle with mental health issues over the last couple of years. I even tried documenting it on this video here, and since then I've been doing great. Obviously, I've moved to uni in that time, and at the start of that journey, I really did miss home. I felt more secure and safer back in Dorset. But now I'm here in Guildford, and after a couple of months, I've really settled in. I've got great friends, great company, and I feel a lot more content in my life. But the truth is, not all students feel the same. In 2016, over 15,000 first-year students in UK universities reported that they had severe mental health problems. Compare that to the approximately 3,000 in 2006. And that was 4 years ago. I dread to think what the statistic looks like now. From 2010 to 2015, there's been a 210% increase in reports of a mental health issue, and that causing students to drop out of university. The students who are most likely to report past issues for which they need professional help identify as female in their first year and between 18 and 20, and ethnically white. There can be many reasons given for why this might be the case, and I won't claim to know the answers, but some of these reasons might be the wider awareness of mental health increasing. That first statistic shows the increase in reports of people's failing mental health. Perhaps it's the emergence of social media, causing an unnecessary pressure on young people to constantly appear at their best, if not the best, and comparing their lives to the broadcasted lives around them 24/7 through apps like Snapchat or Instagram. Or maybe it's just the constant bombardment of negative, depressing news every single day that seems to be filtered into our lives. There are so many reasons, but the truth is we can't change a lot of them. So what can we do? Well, taking a student's perspective, universities are already doing at least something to help. My own uni, the University of Surrey, holds a Centre for Wellbeing, Counselling, a nightline where students can phone in anonymously and have someone to talk to, as well as online services and regular campus events. We even have a mentor who comes in every so often just to check in on everyone, knock on doors and keep them updated on campus events and just to have a friendly face to say hello. All that considered, it's great. And universities all around the UK and the world are tackling this mental health crisis in some way. But much more can be done. For example, this nightline idea is such a fantastic concept, but there's very little advertisement towards it. I don't really want to get into addressing exactly what unis can do better. I don't feel like I have such a good strong case for that. But what I can do is give a few pointers and a few notes or observations of things that you can do if you feel like you're struggling. Because trust me, I know what it's like to not want to get out of bed, to lie and waste away the day. But for now, here are three very small things that I think can help elevate low mood. And perhaps it will inspire you to take some action and seek the help that you might need. Number one is walking. I've talked about it a lot on my channel, the process of going for a walk. Whether you live in the heart of London or the top of the Lake District, going for a walk and taking pictures of your surroundings gives a sense of escape. It allows you to ground yourself in where you are and what you're doing. Maybe one afternoon, if one of the billion storms aren't rolling in, just set aside some time and just by yourself go for a walk, somewhere you haven't been before. Take deep breaths and appreciate the beautiful world around you. And then number two is escapism. I mentioned it a second ago, but this idea of finding an escape from your normal routine has a profound effect on your mental health. Be it a binge-worthy Netflix marathon, or an adventure on the PS4, or even a good old-fashioned book, delve into a world where your problems can't be touched. For a couple of hours a day with friends, preferably, or by yourself, just allow yourself to escape. But make sure this isn't all you've got. Allow it to flow into a consistent daily routine. And third and finally, create something. Many degrees or career paths stifle your creative freedom. So allow yourself to invest time into a project. It could be a piece of writing, coding, painting, filming, dancing, singing, anything. Don't set boundaries or expectations. Just allow yourself to make something. And that's one of the many reasons I have this YouTube channel I've been posting for 2 years. It filters into that last point about escapism. It gives me a chance to create something and put time into a project and reap the benefits and satisfaction. And I'm going to slip this bonus point in there, talk to someone. I beg you, just talk to someone. Mental health is a topic of much discussion in this modern world, and apparently 1 in 4 people suffer daily. So please, if you are watching this video right now, go and message someone. Or even better, talk face to face with someone you might know that might be suffering, or even if you are suffering yourself. Engage in a conversation. It doesn't have to be directly about the issue, but just begin talking. Have that communication with someone and let it flow. Let it see where it goes, and hopefully it will do you a tremendous amount of good. And if you feel like those glory days might never come again, or if there's no silver lining on the horizon, do me a favor and call this number. It's the Samaritans Helpline. It's anonymous, it's brilliant, and they're going to help you so much. And I promise things will get better. Or maybe just leave a comment on this video. I'll happily engage in conversation with anyone that does. Let's have a discussion about this, and hopefully we can see a change. Because sometimes that's all it takes. Just one conversation. A deep, honest, and meaningful conversation. Thank you for watching. My name's Thomas Sinkinson, and have an amazing day. Thank you.